calculation of design seismic force by dynamic analysis method. For a building, the dynamic property, natural period and mode shape is given. Natural period is TA. T suffix A is called natural period. And mode shapes. See, what is mode shape is, if you have a single floor, ground floor is there, plus one. If you have only one floor, you will be having one mode shape. And if you have two floors, you have two mode shapes. Understand simply like this. Your building is having three number of floors, you have three mode shape. This is your figure. You imagine that. If you have three number of floors, this floor one, one, two, three. Three number of floors, you have three number of mode shapes. And if you want to consider for roof also, you can take that. But in this problem, they have not considered for roof, only for three floors. Mode shape is the relative value. If you consider the first floor versus the second floor, what is the displacement difference which happens in each floor? That is called mode shape. If first floor is displacing 4 mm, second floor is displacing 6 mm, then 6 by 4, 1.5. So your mode shape will be 0, ground floor is 0, 1, 1.5. It is a relative factor. What is the displacement of each and individual floor with respect to a single floor? Obtain the design seismic force in X direction of dynamic analysis method outlined by class. They have given the class, distribute with the building height. So these are the given data. Note that all the mode shapes are starting from 1. With respect to roof, what is the displacement of third floor? Roof has largest displacement. From here you can see roof will be having largest displacement. With respect to roof, the third floor is displacing to less deflection only. That is 0.9, 0.74, 0.44. And ground floor will be 0. This is first floor. Below that you have ground floor. The ground floor value will be 0. First step, model mass. How to find model mass? Summation of W into phi divided by G into W phi square. Do you have this factor? Below that you write and you draw this table. Story level, how many floors are there? 1, 2, 3 and 4th floor is roof. So you have 4 number of floors. What is the weight on each floor? 4200, 4200. Third floor is also 4200 and last floor is 3000 in terms of kilonewton. Now, mode shape 1. Do you have mode shape 1 here? This is mode shape 1. Write down all the values. 1, 0.9, 0.716, 0.441. All the values are written here. Now, how to find this? You have to multiply W into phi. What is W? Weight. Phi is mode shape. Multiply this and write in this next column. Now you multiply these two value and write in next column. 1 into 3000 will be this and 0.9 into this value should be next. Then add all the values and write the total here. This is the total. What is the second mode shape? 1.216, 0.701, 0.921. The same thing you have to write it here. Now this is for second mode shape. Multiply. What is the formula here? W into phi. So this is your phi value. Multiply minus 0.921 into 4200. You will be getting these values. Again you multiply 0.921 into 3868. The value will be 3000. The same way for mode shape 3. The mode shape is written here. Multiply by the weight. Last value will be 3000. Now you got all the values. Now you can find this MK. What is meant by MK? Model mass. Now you can divide these two values. Summation of W into 5 square. So you have W into 5. This value summation divided by W 5 square. This value. You divide these two into G. What is G? 9.81. 14,45,000. 160, take it as 161. And this will be the answer. Now, here percentage of total weight is, you add all the loads here, you will be getting 15,600. You can, so divide 14,45,000 divided by 15,600 into 10 power 3. You will be getting 92%. The same way, divide these two values. 95,700 divided by 15,600 into 10 power 3, 6.1. Yes. Next value, divide these two, 1.0. Yes, value is 1%. Now go to next step. Up to this, you have already done. Percentage of total weight, up to this, you have done. Add one more row, which is called PK. You have all these values. W into 5, W into 5 square, summation. Divide these two values, you will get model participation factor. Step 2. Step number 3. AK. AK is defined by design horizontal acceleration spectrum value as per 6.4.2. Z by 2, SA by G, I by R. What are the values you have? Do you have mode shape? First mode shape and this value. Do you have this in given data? T1. If you know T, can you find this value horizontal acceleration? What is the zone given in this problem? Zone 5. Zone 5 is 0.36. Now, after finding T, can you find SA by G? If your value of T is 0 to 4, you can take 2.5. So what is your TA now? 0.8. Then it will come in second case, 0.4 to 4 seconds. Z zone you know, 0.36. What is importance factor? Other buildings. I is other building, hence it is 1. You know all the value. Now you can find AK for first mode as 0.0418. You have 3 modes, you have to find 3 acceleration. What will be second SA by G? 2.5. Yes. Rest of the values will be same. Z, I, R, all the values are same. 0.09. Same value. Now you can write this in Q. What is Q? AK you have found out here, 0.418. 5. 5 is called the mode. So you have this mode 1.240. Do you have this earlier? 1.240. This value you have. And 0.329, 0.118. The same value you can write it here. 5 pk value is this. Third step is over. Lateral load calculation by model analysis. Floor levels are known. We have 4 number of floors. The respective loads are written here. 4200, same and 3000. We know the phi, that is mode shape. Mode shape is given in data and you can write it here. All the 3 mode shapes. If they have given 4 mode shape in any data, you can add it. Why? Because for 4 number of floors, generally you will be having 4 mode shapes. In the given data, they have given 3. So you can stick on with this. Phi and W, you can multiply from here. This is phi and this is W. So earlier you have found out these components. 0.0418 into 1.240. These two components are here. You multiply these two components, phi and W1. Y and W1, you will be getting Q1. And when you multiply the second weight and this phi, you get 196.8, 155.9, and last value will be 96. This is lateral force and this is shear force. You have difference between these two. You will be having at first floor, you have the shear force of 604. How you got 604? You have to add all this component. 155.5, 196.8, 153.9 and 96. Getting 604. This is called shear force. V is called shear. So shear, story shear force in each mode. Now, how to find the next value is subtract 96 from this. 604.2 minus 96. What is your answer? 508.2. 508.2 minus 155.9 will be 352.3. Next, subtract this value, you will be getting 155.5. Finally, subtract 155 minus 155, you will be getting 0. What do you mean by that? At the ground floor, basement of the building, you have 604 of shear force. At each and every floor, the shear force will get reduced, and at the roof, if you observe this building, the top of the roof has 0 of shear force and bottom of the building has maximum of shear force, whereas the lateral force is not like this. Q is known as lateral force. Lateral force is 96, 155, 96 and 155. Okay, the same way you can find it for mode 2 and mode 3. You will be getting same value. You can go to step number E. Story shear force due to all modes in the considered modes, different modes. First one, you have to find V1. How to find V1? Here, what is the title of the step is shear force due to all modes. How many modes are here? Three number of modes. So add all this value. V already you have found out 155.5 square plus 88.8 square plus 31.9 square, and V3 can be found out by squaring all the V3 value for different modes. 352.115 square plus 5.2 square the whole square, you will be getting 371 kilonewton. 610 you will be getting. Check that 604.2 square plus 86.2 square plus 14.6 square, you will be getting 610. Now, last step you have lateral force, step F. Lateral force at each story due to all modes considered. Lateral force at roof and F1 at floor levels. You have to subtract the values. This is 182. And next value you got is 371, 510 and 610. So you have to subtract these two values. Last value you got is 182. When you subtract 371, you will be getting the design lateral force due to all modes. Same way, 510 minus 371. Next two values. 510 minus 371, 139, and last value 100, exactly 100, yes. So this value is lateral force at each story. At first floor you have 300 kilonewton of force, second floor 139, third floor 189 and fourth floor 182. At which floor you have highest seismic force? Third floor. In your building, you can have at any point, it might be in last floor or below that. This depends on your structural load and according to your structural detailing. The height might differ, the load might differ, natural period might differ, like that. So, there might be slight change in the seismic force distribution.